Hello, space fans, and welcome to another edition of Space Fan News. Big news, everyone! Or should I say, Big Bang News, everyone! By now, you've probably all heard the news released on Monday that astronomers looking for gravity waves in the cosmic microwave background have actually found some, and it is a direct observation of a period in our universe's history called inflation. If these results are confirmed, this would be the biggest news concerning our place in the universe next to finding life on another planet. And according to Sean Carroll of Caltech, the biggest thing since dark energy. Why? Because it gives us experimental evidence that the period after the Big Bang, known as inflation, occurred. We can see it right there in the CMB directly. Inflation is the time after the Big Bang when the universe expanded very quickly. Exponentially, in fact. See that part after the Big Bang where the universe gets really big, really fast? That's inflation. The universe went through a phase of accelerated expansion for some reason or other. Nobody knows why this happened, but there are many models explaining how it could happen and what it would look like if it did. And this week's announcement found a key predicted feature that should exist if inflation occurred. To understand this a little better, you need to realize that the basic effect of the inflationary era in our universe was to smooth things out. Stuff like density perturbations and spatial curvature, stuff like that. I mean, for example, these blue and red areas in the image of the CMB show the perturbations. Some parts are slightly hotter or cooler than others. But inflation doesn't completely smooth things out. Quantum mechanics says we can't completely do that. There will always be an irreducible amount of jiggle that will survive. Now, to be honest, inflation makes my head hurt, but suffice it to say that the entire point of inflation is to make the initial conditions of our observable universe seem more natural. And to get it to do that, it needs to start in a very particular kind of state, which raises problems among some cosmologists. But it makes predictions which have come true. The universe is the same everywhere we look, and the curvature of space is pretty small. And it also says that the perturbations on top of this basic smoothness are where we will find clues about the inflationary era. Now, there are two types of perturbations astronomers expect to see based on the quantum fields that fluctuated during inflation. The inflation field itself and the gravitational field. And nobody knows what the inflation field is. They just call it the inflation. And it's the inflation that eventually converts into all the matter and radiation in the cosmos. So finding out what that is a big deal. But that hasn't happened yet. But the gravity field we know about. First, we know the waves are there because gravity exists, and it's massless. Second, there is a way to separate the gravity waves from the density changes in the CMB by looking for polarization. Polarization describes the direction of vibration of a wave, and right now all I have time to tell you is they can wiggle this way or that way, and depending on the direction, they're given names. So this week, astronomers using the background imaging of cosmic extragalactic polarization 2 experiment, or BICEP 2 for the rest of us, at the South Pole found a pattern called primordial B-mode polarization in the light of the CMB, just as had been predicted by inflation theory. Now, there's a chance that this finding could be wrong, but there are a lot of cosmologists pretty excited about the result and seem confident in the analysis done by the BICEP 2 team. Now, I can go on forever about this topic, but I only have a few minutes. So please join Scott Lewis and I this week for Space Fan News Live, and we'll go into way more detail about this finding. And you can also bring your questions and comments and join in with us. Next, astronomers using ESO's Very Large Telescope Interferometer have discovered that a hypergiant star, one of the 10 largest stars ever found and is the largest yellow star ever seen, is part of a double star system that is very strange. The hypergiant, known as HR 5171A, is 1,300 times the diameter and 1 million times brighter than the Sun. Using observations spanning over 60 years, astronomers found a second star in orbit around it that is so close that it actually touches the main star. Now, I've told you about hypergiants before on the video on VY Canis Majoris, the largest star ever discovered. But unlike VY Canis Majoris, this star is yellow, which is very rare among hypergiants. We only know of about a dozen or so in our galaxy. Yellow hypergiants are among the biggest and brightest stars known and are at a stage of their lives when they are unstable and changing very rapidly. Due to this instability, they also expel material outwards, forming a large, extended atmosphere around the star. To find the second star in the binary, astronomers made use of a technique called interferometry to combine the light collected from multiple individual telescopes, effectively creating a giant telescope up to 140 meters in size. The new results prompted the team to thoroughly investigate older observations of the star, spanning more than 60 years, to see how it had behaved in the past. They found that it has gotten bigger over the last 40 years, cooling as it grows, and its evolution has now been caught in action. Only a few stars are caught in this very brief phase, where they undergo a dramatic change in temperature as they rapidly evolve. By analyzing data on the star's varying brightness and using observations from other observatories, the astronomers confirmed the object to be an eclipsing binary system, where the smaller component passes in front of and behind the larger one as it orbits. Here, it is orbited by its companion star every 1,300 days. The smaller companion is only slightly hotter than HR 5171A's surface temperature of 5,000 degrees Celsius. Now, this companion star is significant because it can influence the fate of HR 5171A. For example, it can strip off the outer layers, which would have a direct effect on its evolution. Now, even though HR 5171A is 12,000 light years away, if you live in the southern hemisphere, you can actually see it with your naked eye on a clear, dark night. It's in the constellation Centaurus with a visual magnitude of about 6.1 to 7.3. So by all means, get out there and check out the largest yellow hypergiant we've ever seen. Finally, after searching hundreds of millions of objects across our sky, NASA's Wide Field Infrared Survey Explorer, or WISE, has found no evidence of the hypothesized celestial body in our solar system known as Planet X. Now, I'll be honest with you, I had no idea we were still looking for Planet X, but I guess we were. Planet X was this theorized large celestial body that we couldn't see. Many thought it might be a large gas giant in the outer solar system or a small companion star. But astronomers poring over the catalogs created by WISE have found nothing directly related to a specific body. What they have found, though, is way more interesting. They found several thousand new brown dwarf stars they hadn't seen before, which would explain some of the reasons for the Planet X theory. It turns out that brown dwarfs, which are otherwise very hard to see, are easy-peasy to find using WISE. By just concentrating on these objects beyond our solar system, they have found 3,524 stars and brown dwarfs within 500 light-years of our sun. These objects were completely overlooked before, and despite the large number of new solar neighbors found by WISE, Planet X did not show up. Astronomers think there are even more stars out there left to find with WISE. I guess we don't know our own sun's backyard as well as we might think. Well, that's it for this week, space fans. Thank you for watching, and as always, keep looking up.